Welcome back, friends. In this video, we are going to see how to configure the database in our billing system. This is the final video part of billing system project setup. I have already posted, there are 5 videos for a billing system project setup. Okay, all the video links I have given in the video description. Okay, in the data source section, this is the application YAML file. In the data source section, we have a MySQL DB URL. Here billing is a database name, username is a billing. Now we need to create a billing schema, that is billing database we need to create in a MySQL. Then we need to create a billing-admin user. I don't want to keep username also billing, so I want to use billing-admin. Let's open a MySQL workbench, login with the root user. Go to schema section, click this icon to create a schema. Schema name is billing. Schema created, that is database created. Now we need to create a user. Click administration, then click user and privileges. Here you can see add account button. Click add account. I want to create a username. Billing admin, right? Billing admin, copy that, just paste it in the user section, login name field. Then password is what is the password? Billing $123, copy that, paste that in password field, again paste that in confirm password, then apply. Now billing admin user created. After creating a billing admin user, we need to provide permission to billing admin user. By default, this billing admin user does not have any permission to access the database and the database tables. Okay, we have to provide the permission. For that, we need to select a billing admin, go to administrative roles, then click DBA. If you click DBA, the billing admin user will get all the permission to manipulate the database. Then click apply. Now we have provided the permission to billing admin user. In the home, this is a root user connection. Now I want to create a connection for my billing admin user. For that, I'll go to close this now. The MySQL connection, click plus icon. The connection name, type billing admin connection. Then username is a billing admin. The username by default shows root. Type here billing-admin. Password is a billing $123, I think. What is the password? Yeah, billing $123. Click OK. Click the test connection. Successfully made the MySQL connection. Then click OK. Now here you will get a new box, that is a billing admin connection. Double click that, it will open with the billing admin user. When you select schemas, you can see billing database and the system database. Now we have configured database, we created a billing database, and then we created a billing admin user, then we have provided access to the billing admin to manipulate the database. That's it. Since we are using Flyway DB library, it will create all the DB, it will create all the table for us. The resource DB migration folder, I have written some SQLs. This SQL contains all the table definition. This SQL contains default roles, roles data. Whatever roles we are maintaining, those roles data available here. I'm inserting. Then this is for creating a JWT token table. This is for, I want to keep some static value for system codes. I will explain about this later in the separate video. Okay, this will go to insert. This data will go to insert in system codes table. Okay, whenever we start the server now, it will connect to the billing database. Then it will create all the tables. Okay, it will insert some all the roles, whatever roles I have provided here. Then it will create a JWT token table, then it will insert this data to in system course. Before starting the server, make sure that you created the billing database, you created the user, you have provided the permission. That's it. Now we can start the server. Before starting the server, I want to show the database. In the billing database, we don't have any table now. Once we started the server, Flyway framework takes this SQL and execute all the tables, all the queries. Okay, let me start the server now. Billing system application, right click, run. When you look at the console, it will show all the SQL statement. See here, there is a creation table, alter table, some SQL queries are executing. Server is started now. Let me check the database. I'm refreshing it. See, all the tables are automatically created. Now we have 100% completed the billing system setup. Let me check the server is running or not properly. In the test controller, I have created one endpoint called ping. Using this ping method, using this ping endpoint, we can test our application is working or not. Go to browser, localhost colon 9091 /api/test/api/public/test/ping. It's not coming. The reason is this particular endpoint is not accessible by public. In such a way, it's configured. To access this endpoint, we need to add this endpoint in the security configurer. The security configurer, there is an instruction called the configure method. The configure method, we need to add this. I will commit this change. Again, I'm restarting the server. Server is restarted now. Yeah, server is restarted now. Let me check the endpoint now. See, now server is running. Okay, since we have added the security, by default our application never allows all the endpoint in public manner. Okay, without authorization, it never allows. Okay, that's the reason previously it was giving the forbidden error. After adding the particular endpoint in this method, it's allowing. These methods are publicly accessible. Whatever endpoint you are going to add in here, whatever path you are going to add here, those path publicly available. After adding this particular path, I'm able to access the endpoint. So billing system is working fine now. Please try by yourself. If you face an issue, please let me know. Definitely I will help you out. Still, I have to post one video using Eclipse. This using IntelliJ, right? I have to post one more video using Eclipse. I will going to do that soon. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it. Share this video to your friend circle. Click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.